coming. My name is Jim Brown. I'm director of the Rutgers-Camden Digital Study Center. You are here at the second annual R-CADE Symposium, that is the Rutgers-Camden Archive Digital Ephemera. Some of you might have been here last year when we talked about the Game Boy camera as our shared artifact. This year's shared artifact is Uncle Buddy's Phantom Funhouse, a work of electronic literature that is on display in the gallery right now as part of the electronic literature show. Yes, what you see. Joey?
Yeah.
The camera is blocking the projector just like the
That's my head.
Oh, no, your head is.
Yeah, sorry.
Okay. So what we've done is we've gathered a group of scholars here today to talk about this work of electronic literature that uses sound, print, HyperCard software to deliver a very compelling narrative that involves the reader in the narrative. And I want to give just some very brief framing remarks about Uncle Buddies for people who haven't directly engaged it and what you're going to be hearing about today. If you go into the gallery today, it's the last day of the show, so if you do want to see it, you should go right after this event. You can see it at 8 o'clock, it goes away. This is what you would see in the gallery, a box with a bunch of materials. You can play some songs on a cassette deck. You can interact with Uncle Buddy's Phantom Funhouse in an old Macintosh Classic. And what would happen is you would sit down and you would read me first, and you would see something like this, that it kind of explains to you that you have been left these materials by your by someone named Arthur Buddy Newkirk, who may or may not have been called Uncle Buddy, and you may or may not remember this person for various reasons. This is how the story begins. So the reader is involved, from the beginning. You are sort of involved in the story, or part of the story. You have to actually accept the kind of terms of this agreement that you will read this, these materials, that you will accept responsibility for them. You can see it says, I, Jim Brown. That's because I have entered my name into the funhouse, to enter into the funhouse. And then you would come to the home card of this piece, the home hyper card, and you would navigate via links. And earlier today, John McDaid was here, who's the author of Funhouse, here saying, John, can you raise your hand, stand up? Led us in a workshop on HyperCard, kind of walking us through this system that is no longer available. But I want to show you just a few components of the Funhouse, since you're going to be hearing more about them from our speakers. First is, a set of tarot cards that are part of the story. One of our speakers will be speaking about these. There's an entire set of these cards. And also a conference that's referenced in the narrative called Spasticon. And an entire set of papers and roundtables that would have happened at this conference. And in fact, one of the roundtables you might notice there at the top, you don't know who this is yet, but one of the people presenting is Stuart Malter, who I'll be introducing here in a second, who's here in this room. And let's see here. Also, an important part of this story is the band, The Reptiles, and some of their music. And you're going to be hearing more about The Reptiles as well, and a lot of their work. So, what is the R-CADE, and why are we here talking about the Bloody Sense of Funhouse? The archive of digital ephemera here is not an archive in the traditional sense. We don't archive objects and put them under glass. We actually hand them over to people and say, take them apart, repurpose them, remix them, do with them what you will. That's what we do here for the R-CADE. So, the people that we have invited here today have done very interesting things with Uncle Buddy's Phantom Funhouse. I'm going to very briefly introduce you to them, and then I'm going to get out of the way so you can see the more interesting stuff. First is Robert Evans, who's a documentary filmmaker and also assistant director of the associate director, of the Digital Studies Center, who's made a number of documentary films and also teaches here at Rutgers-Camden in the Digital Studies Center. Steph Sarasa, assistant professor of English at the University of Maryland, Baltimore County, who specializes in sound studies, and her, for instance, her In Progress book is called Sounding, Composition, Composing Sounds. That's still the title?
For now.
And for now. Darius, I'm just now realizing, I don't know if it's Kazemi or Kazemi.
Kazemi.
Kazemi?
Yep.
Okay. I've only ever read it, and I've never heard anyone say it. or at least not correctly, who is an internet artist and co-founder of Field Train, a creative technology cooperative in Portland, Oregon. He makes generally, as he would explain, weird stuff on the internet, bots, Twitter bots, all sorts of random generators of things. Stuart Malford is also here, who I've just recently referenced, is actually makes an appearance in Uncle Buddy's Phantom Funhouse, who is a professor of English at the University of Wisconsin-Milwaukee, author of countless works of electronic literature and things that sit between electronic literature and games, one of which is in the gallery right now, Victory Garden, which was published in 1991. Yes?
Thank you.
And finally, John McDaid is here, who won't be presenting per se, but I think we'll have perhaps questions for him after the presentation. So with that said, I think we're going to get started.